This video covers three autumn sessions fishing the bird sanctuary stretch at Ferrybridge on Chesil. It's my go-to area if the Adelaide swims are occupied, and it's also a great choice for smoothbound fishing in late spring. For the first session, I'm fishing between the first and second posts. I'm primarily targeting bream, but other fish do turn up. I've had quite a few undulates from this area in the past. I've set up short snood clip down rigs, one with lugworm on size 3 Aberdeen hooks and the other with ragworm on size 6s and 8s. That's on the left hand rig, and those hooks are Camazen B983s. At times I'll tip the bait with squid. I've also got a standby rig, a 2 hook version with size 4s. I'll put slightly bigger baits on here to target a better bream and hopefully triggerfish. Triggerfish can turn up here, but you're more likely to catch them over the Adelaide or the landing craft. I'm looking to fish at 70 yards plus, but you can catch fish dropping much shorter than that. As I'm casting out my second rig, I'll run through the locational details. My previous Chesil videos have covered a regional setting, so here I'm just starting with the southern end of Chesil. You'll need a boat to cross the fleet to fish at Langton Herring, but the bridging camp, you can walk to that, if you've got legs for it and are fit enough. I stick to areas closer to Chesil centre. However, the closer you can get towards the bridging camp, the more likely of getting a decent day's fishing. Bird sanctuary is marked out by posts on the top of a shingle on the fleet side. At the time of making this video, there were 10 posts. You park at the Chesil Centre car park, walk past the Adelaide swims, and choose a spot to fish or fit in wherever it's available. For this video, I'll fish near post 2, 5 and 9, in that order. When it's running hard, you need a bag of stones to secure your tripod, but that's not required today, and conditions look perfect for bream. Didn't take long to get the first tapping bites, but hitting them is another matter. Should I get lots of bites I can't hit, then I might resort to using a tube boom rig, but I'd only really do that if I think there's only small fish about. I normally prefer to use ragworm, but sometimes lugworm can be better, and if you're hoping to get codling, then lugworm is really your bait. The rig I'm about to cast out is one I'd normally be using for plaice. They're not usually caught at this end of Chesil, but this rig also catches other fish. Sometimes holding the rod helps you get a bite smaller. After a frustrating session of missed bites, I've gone down to one rod to see if that makes any difference, and I've swapped over to a tube bream rig to see if I can hit any bites. That seems to have worked, and eventually I managed to hook something. I've got 8 pound fluorocarbon and size 12 hooks on this rig, and coupled with tiny bits of bait, I've managed to hook a small bream. Scaling down allows you to avoid a blank, but these aren't really the fish I've come here for. I'll get another one on the next cast, which shows how effective this rig is, but I'd rather not be getting these rather than getting much bigger sized fish. Then switch back to the proper rigs. I get a slightly better bite on my left hand rod, but I get snagged up. I can feel that there's a fish on, and I don't really want to lose it. few gentle tugs, it seems to come free. At last, it's a better sized bream. Then dragging the baits gets me another better bite. The fish are putting up quite a good fight, and I know it's not a bream. It has kited and makes a few lunges over the gutter. Avoid losing the fish, you've got time beaching it well. Fortunately, I've got it in, and it is what I suspected. Pleased to say that I've managed to chalk up yet another decent Chesil triggerfish. Not a triggerfish this time, but another decent sized bream. Activity increases as the sun is starting to set. If only I was catching them of this size at the start. Not the best of sessions, but I ended up with 6 black bream, 3 of which were took, and of course that triggerfish. There were a lot of small fish around today, and they were a bit of a nuisance. I could have caught a lot more if I had fished that tube boom rig a lot of the time, but sometimes you've got to sacrifice quantity for quality. My next session was in the middle of this stretch, but it was a bit of a disaster in terms of filming. My main cameras lost their settings after a firmware upgrade, and the footage was unusable. Once again, the session was a little bit slow, but I did end up with 7 bream and a most welcome codling. That fell to a small bit of lugworm on the rig I normally use for sole fishing. It was a spectacular sunset, and once again, I was really eager to come back and have another go. That was at the beginning of October, and I've hooked a decent fish on my very first cast. What a great start, a codling to the 3 hook clip down rig with lugworm. For this session I've chosen to fish between the 8th and 9th post, and I've started about an hour and a half before the top of the tide. I'm using the same gear as before, Comic Zero 7 rods, Pen Affinity 7000s and 30lb braid. With this I use shock leaders of 45lb mono. I've set up a panel pulley rig as well as that free hook rig that I caught that codling on. Pulley rig is relatively light, with penneled Nordic bend hooks, and I'm targeting the codling with this, with double or treble black lug, sometimes tipped with a squid head. Once again, it's not much of a tidal pull, but pleased to say, since I've got both rigs out, I get a bite straight away. And it looks like I'm into my second fish on my second cast. And fish number two is a reasonable black bream. Having recast that rod, I get another bite fairly quickly. It's another decent fish on. Unfortunately, it slips a hook on the way in. I was convinced that was a better sized codling this time. Unfortunately, it wasn't on the pen or pulley rig, but on that single lugworm and a small hook. I wind in the pen or pulley rig and something takes it on the way in. It's a pretty big mackerel, so that'd be coming home with me. Before I can unhook it and photograph it, my other rod goes. It's all action today, and I can't believe the start I've had. This is a decent sized fish, I don't want to lose it. It doesn't feel like a codling. The fish kites to the right as it moves over the gutter. Can't believe my luck. The first five casts, I've got four decent fish and lost a big codling. This isn't the biggest of trigger fish that I've caught here. Nevertheless, it's still a decent fish and it put up a good fight. Black luck is certainly working well today. Having just recast both rods, I can't believe I'll get another bite straight away. And I'm into another fish. It's another decent sized black bream. Having caught a mackerel by accident, I now fancy my chances of catching one feathering. So I'm setting up my comic Arcadia rod for this. But before I could finish setting up that rod, I'm spotting bites on the other ones. That's a decent knock on the rod for the panel putty rig. And that's species number 5, and arguably the best looking of the lot. It's a decent sized and quite spectacular red gurnard. As a fellow angler comes to see me, I'll get another good bite. Unfortunately, fish comes off, and I'm thinking that's the second codling that I've lost. After a short quiet spell, the bites resume. I can't believe my luck, another codling comes in. Smaller black bream this time. Thank you. Things quieten down a bit, and the tide is now ebbing. Weather turns a bit nasty, and it's time to try what I call a sole rig. Shorter hook lengths seem to be working better than a longer hook length on a pen or pulley rig, and this rig caught me a codling last time, so it's worth another try, yeah. Well, it was worth trying that sole rig, as it produces another decent sized bream. I'm now getting pestered by little knocks, so I'm assuming the smaller bream have moved in. Well, they are smaller, but not that little. The action continues, but it's only from those smaller bream, and I now got a double shot. I had a couple of goes with feathers during the day, but that didn't produce anything. But to finish off the session, I decided to chuck a large ragworm into the gutter. That was on a panel pulley rig, and I couldn't believe my luck when I got a slack liner. No spectacular sunset to finish off the session, but it's been a spectacular day. One of the best starts to a session that I've ever had, and I couldn't believe my luck when I get a bass on my last cast. No specimen, but that tops off a fantastic day.